Welcome. Thanks for joining us. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the Texas Rangers and the Arizona Diamondbacks. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about ready to go. And on the mound here today, Zach Gallen.
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over?
Throws to second, and he's out, trying for two. So now it's Corey Seager. First pitch just misses. One out, base is empty. Next offering is in for a strike. Gallen cites the fact that as a kid he had small hands, and that allowed him to develop his changeup. Still, this one swung on and hit well. Way back there. Grabs it right up against the wall. And now we take a look at the Rangers lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Two outs. Pitch misses. Yeah, the count one and two.
This guy at the dish excels in two strike counts. Got to be careful with him out there on the mound.
Swing and a pop up. Foul territory for the catcher. Moreno makes the play, and that is that. Rangers go down quickly there, and now Arizona gets. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. This is Corbin Carroll.
The right fielder.
And a pitch. That one fouled off. Eovaldi, an all-star a season ago. He features a four-seam fastball, a splitter, a cutter, a curve, and he works in a slider. And the 0-2. Left field coming on. And he can't make the play. Throw cut off to second. Not going to get him. He's in there.
That's one of those errors you make as an outfielder where you just can't believe it. You want to crawl into the grass. Every outfielder at some point muffs an easy one like that, but it feels like one of the most embarrassing things you can do. Hey, we all caught pop-ups in Little League. Nothing particularly difficult about that one. He just didn't see it all the way and put the squeeze on it. I'm sure it won't happen again.
And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell. Fought off foul. Runner at second here, one gone. The pitch. Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
Most guys are very aggressive when they see the stakes out there on the base paths and can't understand why he wasn't ready to swing the bat. You've got to be ready to swing the bat in a situation like that with the go-ahead run in scoring position.
Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Runner at second, two down. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Has a bead on it. He's got it, and that will end the inning. All set for the start of the inning. Now here is Wyatt Langford. And that one fouled off. Langford, 22 years old, a former first-round pick in 2023. Ripped, but it curls foul. Riding to the plate. Line drive, caught!
Yikes, that ball was scorched, an absolute missile, and it almost becomes self-defense as the fielder when one of those things comes screaming towards you. Watch your lips.
Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. That's down. One hops off the wall. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Great hands on that swing to take the inside pitch and drive it into the gap for the double. It's easy to spin off a pitch like that, Boog, and you can pull that thing foul, but that was perfect. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
And that one wrapped foul. Man at second. A rope into right, and that's a base hit. They won't risk the send. Runners at the corners now with one away.
He was all over that one. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and ripped it into the outfield, that's one of those.
Oh, this is deep to left center. Way back there. On its way. Gone. A towering shot. And they jump ahead in the second. It's 3-0. He only needed one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off.
Oh. On to first. Got him. Two outs, bases empty. Here's Leody Taveras.
Center fielder, number three, Leody Taveras.
Liner, base hit. So the two-out knock extends the inning and sends them back to the top of the order.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. There. Nice line drive to the pull side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
Smith in the box now as he looks at ball one. Second plate appearance of the day for him. And there's a foul ball.
I love this part of the game. Does he really want to try and steal second against this catcher? I know he's fast, but it's pretty risky.
The 1-1. Runner takes off. Ball misses. Safe at second with a stolen base. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
That one fouled off. 2-2.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Man on second, two down. On the ground, Marte sends it to first. They limit the damage here. Three-run shot for Texas this inning. It's now 3-0. It's major. Back here at Chase Field, bottom half of inning number two. Stepping in, Lourdes Gurriel Jr.
Gurriel.
And first offering is fouled off. Eovaldi, when you talk about his skill set, he stops teams from getting hits. That's the thing that he's so good at. He's just really difficult to get base hits against.
Well, he's got power, and he has a reputation of being a strike thrower. So, to his advantage, he can expand the zone.
He goes down looking.
No, that's not the best two-strike fastball I've seen, but certainly got away with the location there. You know, sometimes as a hitter, when you're down in the count, you're so focused on a pitcher painting the black, and you just get a little bit locked up on something down the heart of the plate, not expecting it, and it just kind of freezes you.
Way out front for strike two.
He can throw that fastball slightly above the top of the strike zone to get hitters to chase. He can also break it off because when you're geared up for good velocity, it's hard to stay back. You have to make a decision really early.
Just off the inside corner. Now one and two. To the right side, Semien gets it to first. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two. So what's the approach from an offensive perspective against a guy that doesn't give up a lot of hits?
I think you just kind of have to lean out over the plate and, you know, take your base. But seriously, you just have to try to shorten up.
And the throw to first is there to put an end to the inning. So they make short work of them there. We head on now to the top of the third. And we're back. Now it's Corey Seager. As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm, delivers. Now with the shift on, hits right into it. Marte throws to first in time. One up, one down. Here is Marcus Semien. He popped out to the catcher his first time up. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. So a man aboard now with one away.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
So a man aboard. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Wyatt Lankford. Popped foul out of play off to the right. Kicks and fires. Hit in the air, right field. Carroll moving under it. And there's two down.
Now batting,
the right Adolis field. Garcia Adolis. Stepping in for the Rangers. Garcia. Doubled his first time up. Line drive, and that's a base hit out into center field. Lead runner makes the turn at second. And the throw's offline, safe at third.
I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Here's Nathaniel Lowe, and a good eye there. Two on, two outs, and now it's even up.
One and one.
Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. Runner in from third to extend their lead, and it's 4-0.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Two outs. That's towards center. Thomas sizing it up and puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's now a 4-0 ball game. Back here in the desert, set for the bottom of the third. Alec Thomas now. Strike one.
Well, these Diamondbacks, as you probably noticed, haven't been shy at the plate at all. In fact, they've probably been too aggressive at times. I'm specifically talking about the first pitch. These batters are swinging more than 80% of the time, which is fine. You're scoring runs, but that hasn't been the case today.
Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Came after him with the fastball on 0-2, and that's a pretty good demonstration of what power pitching is all about. He's got the stuff, obviously, and right there he used it to put his opponent away without needing to waste any pitches.
This one in the air. Should have this one. Puts it away for the out. Two down.
The right fielder, number
seven.
So
the lineup flips over. Corbin Carroll, the next to hit. That one finds the zone. That's strike one. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt. In the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind.
He locked him up, and that'll do it. The inning is over. And welcome back to the ballpark. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Jonah Heim. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single. So digging in, Leody Taveras. singled and stole a base his first time. And a sack bunt here. And he can't come up with it. No throw. That's an error. And everyone is safe. So the Rangers batting order turns over. Next is the designated hitter, Josh Smith. 1-for-2. Line drive. And that should be extra bases. Rounds third, headed for the plate. One run is in.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch.
So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Bryce Jarvis.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Seager, the next to hit, takes ball one. Right-handed reliever, and a foul ball left side. Tavares, the runner at third. Smith stands at second. No outs. That's off the mark. And the count 2-1. Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Got him. One away on the strikeout. And an excellent job keeping it right there. Now it's Marcus Semien.
Boog, how good was Marcus Semien in 2023? Named a finalist for the MVP award in the American League after producing a season with 100 RBIs, an 826 OPS, and 29 home runs. On top of all that, his Rangers won the World Series.
That one way inside. Just misses. Now 2-2.
It's a good take.
Bounced out to short. Perdomo to first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe. A run comes in the play. So first and second with one man gone. Up next for the Rangers, Wyatt Langford. They say it went.
All one's the count.
Ground ball left side, and that one finds its way through around third. He will score, and they're pulling away up by seven now.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Just one of those seeing eye base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Garcia in the box with one away as he takes ball one. And that one fouled off. Two on, one out. Foul ball. Missed with a changeup, and the count's even at two. Got it. And there's two down. Nathaniel Lowe up to hit.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
On the ground, right side. Bell. The flip to the pitcher covering. That ends the inning and stop. Bottom of the fourth, Ketel Marte up to the plate.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some pitchers. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse. Go after hitters and get quick outs.
That one pushed foul out of play off to the left. The 0-2. And they'll do it again. And the righty deals. And down on strikes he goes. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Now, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way coming from that opposite arm angle. So I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
Next offering in there for a strike. And that's strike two. That one lifted to left on his way over. Hauls it in, and there's two away.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Josh.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's Jack Peterson. Fly to left his first time. That's down and in. Two down, nobody on. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Next offering upstairs. And that one upstairs.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a full scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. The 1-0. He was late there. Strike one. Peterson, the runner at first with two gone. Right through there for a strike. And that one is lifted in the air. Garcia makes a nice running catch. Back here at Chase Field at the plate. Josh Jung. Jarvis back to work. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. And the leadoff man aboard. So next to hit for Texas, Jonah Heim. Swing and a foul straight back. Heim, a former Gold Glove winner, 28 years old, and he was drafted in the fourth round back in 2013. High fly ball down the left field line. Gurriel trying to get there. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away. Man at first. Next up for Texas, Leody Taveras. And first offering is fouled off.
Always tough to turn two on a speedster like this. It's even harder with him coming out of the left-handed batter's box. You really need something to hit hard on the ground that they can handle to turn two quickly.
Pulls that one foul. Man at first, one away. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
This one high in the air to left center. Gurriel handles the chance, and that'll do it. Rangers leave one. We head to the bottom of the fifth, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Gabriel Moreno. And first offering is fouled off.
You know, these D-backs just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. Chasing pitches has been a big part of the story. We've seen it quite a bit today. It's been tough for them to make contact at times, and it just doesn't look like they're seeing it very well as a group.
And that's downed away.
And on the mound, you know, confidence has to be pretty high with all of the swings and misses. He's had them eaten out of the palm of his hand pretty much all game.
Line to left, and it stays fair. And that rolls into the corner. Around first and hustling for second. The relay throw, but he's in there easily.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Just a really nice job of turning on that pitch and smoking it down the line. And there's no one playing there, so once it drops in fair, you're on your way to extra bases.
Throw home, not in time, the run scores. And they're on the board, but lots of ground to make up. So man aboard, Alec Thomas will hit next. Swing and a foul straight back. The pitch. And a swing and a miss.
0-2.
Now a screamer into the outfield. Base hit. Suarez around second, headed for third. Throw comes in. Runner stopped. Second and third. Nobody out.
Everything came together for him. Hitters work so hard on driving the ball gap to gap in batting practice. There's a lot of room out there. And if you can rip one into that open space, it usually
bounces to third. Rolls across the diamond. Finally gets the first out here on the grounder. Corbin Carroll stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
Traffic on the bases with one already in. Last half of inning number five. Out to short. Seager slides, but it gets by him. And he's in safely at third as a run scores. One away, runners at first and third. An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. Just missed. First and third, one down. Next pitch is downstairs.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Swings and misses. And it's 2-1. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Good late cut for the strikeout there. That thing really got in on him, man. You know, the cutter isn't really a huge swing and miss pitch most of the time because it's not really meant to move a whole lot. You're just trying to miss the big part of the barrel and maybe get some weak contact, but that one right there did a whole lot more than that. That was a really good pitch.
Just off the inside edge. Corners are occupied with two down. Lace down the line. This looks like extra bases. One run is in around third. He'll score. Two runs are in. It's 7-4. And it's scoring position with two away. Here's the cleanup hitter for the Diamondbacks, Jock Peterson. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. The throw in, but it's offline.
Well, that gets him a little closer in this one. Timing on the swing.
Here comes the skipper. So out of the bullpen for the Rangers, Josh Spores.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
Tavares settles under it and makes the catch. And the inning is over. So five innings in the books now with the no-hitter officially over. It's the Rangers 7 and the Diamondbacks 5. Top six, and here's Corey Seager to hit. Jarvis back to work. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Gurriel handles the chance.
Almost a loud start to the inning on that first pitch. Man, he's going to want that one back, no doubt.
So up next, Marcus Semien. Swing and a miss, and that one missed by a ton. Movement in the bullpen. Kevin Ginkle up and throwing for manager Torey Lovullo. Floro also throwing. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
What makes him special is a lot of pitchers lose movement in their stuff the deeper they go into a game, but he's just different. We see plenty of break in his pitches, even when he's running a little low in the tank.
Gathers and throws to first. And Semien is out. Two outs, base is empty. Wyatt Lankford stepping in for the Rangers. And that one ripped to left. And that's a fair ball. Makes the turn and heads for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Solid double down the line. And that was a pretty decent pitch that he just turned on. Not really out over the plate. It was inside. But he was more than ready to get that bat through the zone.
High bounce over the fence for an automatic double. And a run comes in to score. Nathaniel Lowe now at the plate.
That ball exploded off his bat and off the warning track as well as it bounced over the fence. And it sounded really good, too. He just put together a really nice swing and just missed a home run.
Very high with that one. And one and one. Ground ball up the middle. Finds its way through, base hit. Here's the throw to the plate. It's offline. The run comes in. Number six, Josh Young. And first offering is fouled off. Two outs. In the air, right side. Carroll moving under it. And he makes the catch. And that is that. Back here in the desert, bottom of the sixth inning. Now the D-backs catcher, Gabriel Moreno. Line drive. Gets down, base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Suarez in the box here. Lets that one go for a ball. Swing and a miss.
One ball, one strike.
As he was out front that time. And strike two.
One ball, two strike.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And a 1-2. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Here's a 1-2.
Two ball.
Now he can't squeeze it behind the plate. And he'll move up to second, no problem. Should be a pass ball, and that takes away the double play. Kicks and deals. And base hit. Moreno around third. And it gets by him. He'll score. It's 9-6. And he's into second with nobody out.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Man, it's second. Swing and a miss. Now two balls and a strike.
One strike.
Back up the middle and a base hit. Tavares returns it to the infield, and that's good enough to hold the lead runner at third. Runners now at the corners. Andrew Chafin enters the game.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big one.
This to center field. Tavares running hard to get it. He's got it, and there's one down.
Up next to the diamond.
Corbin Carroll digs in now. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. Next offering is in for a strike.
Not sure exactly what he was thinking there. Good sinker ball pitcher. Goes with the fastball in a double play situation when he needs something on the ground.
With the tying run at the plate here in the bottom of the sixth. Center field coming on. Makes the grab, tracks it down after the long run. Two down. Here's Ketel Marte. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Suarez on third. Thomas on at first with two down. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul. And a count 1-2. Just misses the mark outside the zone. In the air, out towards left center. Brings it in. That is the inning. D-backs with a run scoring double. It's now 9-6. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Joe Mantiply.
Just trying to keep. this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
And a foul ball. Mantiply, a former All-Star. He features a sinker, a curve, a changeup, and he works in a four-seamer. At the belt and fires. The punch out there, and now one away.
Well, oftentimes that's the pitch he's trying to set up, the curveball. He'll lean on it pretty heavily, so you got to be expecting it, look for it, and sell out so you don't miss it when you get it.
Boots it. And he's going to make it to first, and we'll see how they score it.
Well, it looked like a pretty routine play. Just couldn't get it to stick in the glove as he gets tagged with the error. Should have been two outs in the inning, but now they
runner on the goal. Throw, save. One out and a runner at second here in the top half of inning number seven. Check swing, went around. No balls, two strikes.
No ball, two strikes.
On the ground, right side. Marte tosses to first, and there are two outs. Seager stands in now. 0 for 4, a couple of flyouts. He's also grounded out and struck out. Check swing, he went too far, and it's a strike. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
Let's see if he's willing to use the whole field right here. Definitely pounding him away.
Here's the 0-2. And down on strikes. That's the third out. And we're back, set for the last half of the Bell at the plate now. And a pitch. Right down. To shoot, and it's 0-1. Fastball for a strike.
No ball, two strikes.
Got him. One away.
Well, that was a pretty poor at bat. He just never got the bat off the shoulder. I mean, you got to go up there looking to swing at some point, especially once you're down 0-2. And at that point, make an adjustment, look to put the ball in play if it's anywhere close. And I'm just not sure what the plan was there.
One down, base is empty. Swings through that one for strike two.
0-2 is the count.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. On the ground, right side, and that's just foul. Got him swinging.
Well, they get the strikeout there, and what kind of stood out to me was that they weren't shying away from contact. Every single pitch was in the strike zone, and that tells me they wanted to attack him, and it paid off.
Right side. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Kevin Ginkle. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Now it's the second baseman, Marcus Semien. The pitch. Dives, but it kicks off his glove. And he beats it. He's safe. Man at first. Here's the left fielder, Wyatt Lankford. And that one pulled foul. Ginkle, the tall righty, he features a four-seam fastball, a slider, and he works in a sinker. And the 0-1. Simeon runs. Ball. Pitches low. Throw, and they got him.
Wow, what an incredible throw right there. And he might not have had time to get to his feet and catch that runner. That's an incredible display of arm strength.
One down, base is empty. Lined into right. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
And now, Adolis Garcia in the air, right field. Sizes this one up. Carroll pulls that one down. Now a throw to first, and he won't get back in time. It's a... Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Kirby Yates. Moreno, the leadoff batter, as he looks at ball one. And a foul ball. Fouled off, he was late. And a swing and a miss, down on strikes. One gone to the bottom of the eighth. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. And first offering is fouled off. The D-backs trailing by three here the bottom half of the eighth inning. And that one ripped into right and foul ball. Swings over the splitter for strike three.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
Backed off the plate that time. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Cut on and miss, struck him out. And a nice inning of. We're back. It's the top of the ninth. And there's a new pitcher on the mound, A.J. Puff.
Bringing in the lefty with a left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here. So we'll see how it works out.
The pitch. Liner. And that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. Around second now, going for three. The relay in there safely.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Put a pretty good jolt into that one. Great swing, nice balance and weight transfer, and he got it to drop in out there in the deep part of the field.
Here's Josh Young, and that one clips the corner. Late swing, fouled off. Low at third with nobody out.
One ball
in the dirt, and the runner holds. Outside low, and it's 2-2. Hard hit right side, and he handles it himself for the out. Up next for the Rangers, Jonah Heim. And first offering is fouled off. Ground ball right side. That's a base hit. Run scores.
Well done. Drives in the run. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
And now it's going to be Leody Taveras. This one in the air.
Bell.
As this one sized up, corrals it. Out number two. So now here's the DH, Josh Smith. And that's a base hit. Just kind of slice that one into center. Oh, the throw is wild.
Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Coming home. He'll score easily. It's 11-6.
Picks himself up at RBI. Got the top of him.
Dylan Floro takes over on the mound.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
Right-hander kicks, deals. On the ground to the left. They get the force, and the inning is over. And the batter will be the shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo. And here comes. Popped up. Catcher tosses the mask, settles under it, makes the catch, and there's one down. So back to the top of the Arizona lineup. Now it's the right fielder, Corbin Carroll. The Rangers leading by five. Here in the last half of inning number nine. Lobber to right field, way back, gone! A gigantic blast. And they close the gap. It's 11-7. That one just sounded different.
And it might have been the loudest moment yet. Man, my ears are ringing. I can feel that swing from the booth.
Two strikes.
On the ground to first. And he takes it himself for the out.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run. Not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter. And a tough one at that.
Bell in the box with two gone. And takes a look at a called strike. The Diamondbacks down to their final strike. Foul ball, it stays nothing and two. The Rangers leading by four. We're in the last half of the ninth inning. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game. An 11-7 final score. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon. First for the victorious Rangers, 11 runs on a whole bunch of hits. Two errors, they left them.